The metaverse will have, to start with, it doesn't really exist yet. It's still got a long way to go and lots of pieces to come together. But when it does come together, one of the components of it will be digital people.
My identity and personality were crafted by blending features like skin texture and tone, face shape, eye color, voice, language, and of course, hair. Now, in minutes, anyone can create a unique, high-quality digital person that embodies the soul of a brand.
So you'll have real people interacting with each other through avatars, but you'll also have all the things which need to be autonomous when we're interacting with each other. We are very complex beings, and so to have true interaction with technology, you need a really holistic approach. Now, human cooperation is the most powerful force in history. It's put a person on the moon, it's created medicine, incredible works of art, and so forth. But it's human cooperation with intelligent machines which will define the next era of history.
The metaverse, we are all avatars, and it would be very easy for me to get an avatar for myself impersonating, I don't know, Asaf here. And I would be going all over the place as Asaf and then saying hi.
Feel free.
Exactly. The thing is, I need to demonstrate that this is me and not him. So in order to do that, I will need to use my cryptographically enforced wallet. What else do I need? Well, look at this, for instance. Decentraland offers you the possibility to play using your wallet. So at least it is cryptographically enforced. It's one step beyond. Okay? Then tokens. What do we tokenize? Whatever you tokenize, you can put it on, obviously, the blockchain. So we will be tokenizing everything, transactions, etc., anything from property, real estate, contracts, become a token. Any asset that you can divide into little pieces, and then you put these pieces on the blockchain. Okay? If it is a monetary transaction, you use cryptocurrencies. If it's non-monetary, you use an NFT, okay? A non-fungible token that represents whatever you want, okay? And then, what do you need? Well, imagine, for instance, if I want to generate a token right now for you to be able to demonstrate that you were here today, I would be generating a POAP, a proof of attendance protocol token, that you could mint to demonstrate, for instance, on LinkedIn, that you were attending this session. And we will be doing that all the time. Then smart contracts. This is a piece of code. If the clauses happen, then the conditions get fulfilled and you get something in return. And on top of this, you can build a full corporation. What is a corporation? What is a company? A bunch of contracts. So you can build a decentralized autonomous organization on top of that. So these are the structures, these are the things we need to build the metaverse. If you check the Decentraland, you will realize that they have, the moment you open an account with your wallet on Decentraland, you become a citizen. And as a citizen, what can you do? You can vote. You can make decisions. Okay, this is more like akin to what we are imagining as the metaverse. It's still very limited, but on top of this, of something completely decentralized, open, etc., this is where we need to imagine the place where we will be relating, talking to each other, working, etc. If we miss the cryptographically enforced part, we will be basically playing video games.
We develop technologies, really amazing stuff, but at the end of the day, you know, we're human beings, and this basic interaction between us that you cannot compensate for in the digital world. So, and I think this haptic challenge is huge. It's actually very tough to do that. Okay, it requires a lot of stuff on you, I don't know, cumbersome solutions. So I wouldn't take that technology there, not in the beginning. We have to start with the basics. But, you know, I can see my kids, you know, they're all the time with the technology with them. I don't like them to be there so much. I would really appreciate if they can balance their lives, see their friends, and then, you know, use technology where you need to use that. That's personally my opinion.